Let me tell you about the Oscars. Well, Ghana recently selected Kwabena Jansah's Azali as its submission for the International Feature Film category at the 2020 Oscars. It is the first time Ghana has submitted a film to the Oscars amidst concerns of not meeting the eligibility criteria. Well, we have some good news for you, as the Ghana International Oscar Selection Committee will be holding its annual submission workshop on the theme International Oscar Submissions, Language, film styles, campaigns, and requirements. Joining us in the studio is Ghanaian-American filmmaker Leila Jansah, who is also advisor to the Ghana Selection Committee. Leila, you're welcome to join
us. Thank you.
Is this the first time you've been here?
Yes, it is.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
So, I mean, it's exciting to know that Ghana, you know, is getting all the way up there, you know, getting to the Oscars. Mm-hmm. But already people are concerned because of what happened to Lionheart.
Yes.
So, well, if you're not, you don't follow these conversations so much. So Lionheart is a movie, Nigerian movie, produced by Genevieve Naji, and then, you know, everybody was excited because she also got nominated, and then she didn't win. But
it wasn't nominated, actually. It was submitted.
It was submitted, mm-hmm. but it was not nominated.
Nothing has been nominated yet. The shortlist is not out. So you submit your film, mm-hmm. and what the Academy does is they vet all the films, and then they approve the films that qualify, that met all the requirements.
Okay.
So what happened with Lionheart is it was 97% English.
Okay.
And it's supposed to be 70% foreign language.
Okay.
But with Ghana,
that's because of the criteria.
The criteria set, exactly, because she submitted for foreign language, which is now international Oscars. So if she submitted for the international category, but then it was not supposed to be in English.
Okay.
And it was in English.
Okay. What do you first heard that story? How did you feel?
I was not surprised, because when I saw the announcement that Lionheart is what was representing Nigeria, I made a comment on one of my friends Amma's page, and I said, "This is gonna get disqualified."
Oh, you said that.
But then, I mean, you gotta say those things carefully, because they're like, you know.
Okay.
So I kind of said it, muted.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. But that's because could there have been a different category that this film could have,
which is not Lionheart,
successful.
It could have gone to the main Oscars, but then Netflix, which is the distributor, would have had to push it. But the question is,
Netflix has so many others.
Exactly.
Right?
Is it as good as the other films that are getting in, you know, like Once Upon a Time in Hollywood? You have Greta Gerwig's, is it Lady Bird, or is it, I think, Little Women? You know, there are a lot of strong films, you know, even Clemency, which is one of my favorite films of this year, made by a Nigerian-American filmmaker, Chinoye Chukwu. Mm. It did not even get the Golden Globes.
Okay.
Right, so.
So this was more like, this was like a space where Nigeria, a Nigerian movie, could have thrived, but for the language.
In the international category. I mean, whether it would have thrived, I don't know, because the kind of films that go for the international Oscars, if you look at the history of the international Oscars, the scope is pretty big. And the scope of Lionheart, it was a very pretty film, very cute film, but it's a very small scope.
Yeah.
And even with what we sent Azali still is also a small scope.
Okay, so let's get to the Azali conversation proper. It's been submitted as
yes.
well. Okay, what's in Azali that should perhaps do the trick for us that Lionheart didn't do?
Well, Azali met the requirements, all the requirements. And one thing that the committee, what we did was we held the hand of the filmmaker. We made sure, for example, he could not get his sound done in Ghana. He had to send me the sound, and I had to get the sound people in LA to do his sound. So we held his hand, and we made sure we were following the guidelines of the Academy, which was the key thing, because it's their award. If you want to submit to their award, you follow their rules.
Yeah.
And he came to the Ghana Oscar Committee. We had a workshop 2 years ago in 2017. And he was there. So he knew he wanted to shoot a film that he was going to submit to the Oscars.
Okay.
That is what he did.
Okay. So tell us about the program that you're holding here in Ghana, the Oscar committee.
So because of what happened with Lionheart, and when we received submissions, we realized there were a lot of people who submitted in English.
Okay.
People submitted, oh my God, I'm going to say this. There was this film that was submitted with Van Vicker in a wig as a white man. I'm like, really? Come on, y'all. Come on, y'all. Come on. Come on. But so there were, we had to filter through very interesting films that were submitted. Okay. And so the workshop is really to get people to understand what kind of films you should submit. Understand what has the potential. So when you go make your film, you do not assume that any film you make has the potential of going to the Academy.
Okay.
So the workshop is going to shed light on the requirements, how to campaign, because really Oscars is all about optics.
Yeah. So and what's the date and how do people get in?
It's going to be on Wednesday, the 18th of December, starts at 9 a.m. at the ATIC, which is right opposite Afrikiko Gardens.
Okay. And what was it about Azali that really did it?
For me as a voter on the Ghana Oscar Committee, it was its soul. It was the heart of the main character and the journey, because she had a strong hero's journey, and that is what made me vote for it. The voting is very transparent. I don't know what any other person voted for. So for me, it was the heart of that little girl, Asana, and the journey she went through was tough. And you do see a lot of other young girls. It is a timely topic. You have the issues of Kayaye, you have child trafficking. It is a very timely topic, which is global, not only Ghana. Trafficking is everywhere.
Yeah. Interesting. Final words, Leila, before you go.
Please show up to the workshop. All the questions that you have are going to be answered if you show up to the workshop. And we're going to have food, and it's free.
Do you speak Ewe, right?
I speak Ewe.
Okay, so I want you to connect to those in your hometown who have not seen you in a while.
Okay, me de kuku piki kule savio fe to meva piki last weekend. Today's for Monday, me no piki Saturday. And piki kule savio to hello to you guys. Eho to pite hello. Me de kuku mi ano Joy FM bosia. Mi a love radio che.
So she says that she watched Joy News, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
She says that she watched Joy News. She said she was there over the weekend.
Yes.
And that they should watch Joy News.
They should watch Joy News.
That's it.
Yes.
That's it.